Personally, if I could talk to my friend again from Sioux Falls, my best friend in Pry, I would encourage him. I hope you do not get STDs from Jessica. And I've seen a good wrestler prior, one of the most profound people prior to my best friend who got STDs from Jessica. Good thing that they were not permanent STDs, and it was more of a learning experience. So I want to congratulate him on that, on being an overcomer. And then it's amazing. I've seen a classmate join the army and had a sweetheart girlfriend prior. He joins the army, comes back, he gets a wrong girlfriend, and his girl before he went into the army was one to have a courtship with. It was complete happiness. Well, that wrestler ended up being an alcoholic later on. So things happen. We're living in a 25-year span of things that can happen. Prior in my life, in 2000, I started a business plan. Now we're in 2021. Been riding, running since age 9 and 10. Yeah. Unfortunately, Cindy Adrian from Freeman, Cindy Adrian being a demon, she got addicted to gambling. It was kind of fun, though. She was gone. I was having more fun being... lack of responsibility too, so I was out till midnight, 7th grade. Absolutely. Cindy was addicted to gambling. Her husband, Alan Adrian, had a good business plan prior. Business plan was not good enough for him, so he started his bowling league with, and then he went ahead and prior, another distraction was Pinochle Club, where they drink once a month and they play cards, but they also drink once a month and play cards. So once you lose your dream, you lose your dream, you reap what you sow. Alan also, he saw a UFO, told children that. Cindy Adrian, before I even hit high school, cool thing is she wrote me a letter on her birthday. The day following her birthday, like I disown you as my son, which was cool. I probably disliked her in 2nd grade as well. 3rd grade though, she wanted to leave me in the desert, going on a vacation with a credit card to California, camping. I don't think camping's really vacation. Nobody camps in Hawaii unless there's a KOA in Hawaii. You reap what you sow here in the Midwest. Either you got a relationship outside of the Midwest or you do not. Cartoon came out yesterday, Lance Adrian 29, so yay upon that. Swine, Adrian and Schmidt, always swine, always say that. That's a consistent I'll say. Demonology, I look at demonology more as a neutral thing. It's completely on the unseen. The education on demonology is zero repetitions. My older cousins on the Adrian side, they never entered the home of Ellen and Cindy Adrian. Never did. Never once. So that's zero rep, and I call that demonology. We just don't talk. Another person who I just don't talk, brother-in-law. I seen Rachel Adrian cry. In 1999, God, it's funny stuff. Very funny. God, where to begin? Well, if I don't begin, then there's always tomorrow where we can begin, because the sunrise comes up, and then technology's free. Let's see. Assholes. I see Fred Tibbetts as an asshole. I seen him get ruthless on. Nate White's an asshole, I think, too. He showed me his penis in gym class, did a prank on me. Hey, look down, Lance. Naturally, I will. Whatever. Showed me his penis. I should have just screamed at him that you're an asshole, Nate White, basketball player. Fred Tibbetts went off, though, on Donnie Lukey, Nate White during class, during dancing class. I just think Fred Tibbetts is an asshole. congratulations, Fred, on all your championships. But you swagger, got that nice swagger, smiley face on you. Good for you. I prefer running and riding since age 9 and 10. Clutch runner with the mile, ran a 6-minute mile, third grade. Building on that, more so doing yoga. Yeah, so if you never got STDs from Jessica in Sioux Falls, good for you. I've seen her take a dream away from a good wrestler named Joe. But I don't think Joe got STDs from Jessica. I never heard about that. So I'm talking about two different people who Jessica has influenced and taken away from because she's a witch. But she was never a witch to me, but she was a witch to two other people because of STDs. And too bad Joe didn't, you know, start his courtship with Amber. Let's see. I think second book's going to come out, though. Second book will probably come out, though. January. Truth and the Fearless. I just want to help people with the book. Read the book and apply the book. Is that all right? What else is there? Yeah, Alan Adrian saw a UFO. Told that. Oh, yeah, Cindy Adrian. Okay. I think she was sexually harassed at work one time from her boss. So she told me that before high school. And then candy, pop also in her life, constantly, cigarettes. You reap what you sow. Swine, Adrian and Schmidt. Other things, Cindy Adrian. She was stalked once at her home in her childhood when living in Freeman. Yeah, weird stuff. She pulled her daughter's hair, Rachel Adrian, in some type of supermarket when Rachel was 18. Just pulled her hair mad. Cindy was mad. That's where I remember her facial expressions. Like, don't use the rewind VCR rewinder machine at all. Or don't use the VCR that can fast forward and rewind, but use this other device here that can rewind. And I'm mad. They're mad. Oh God. One person that's fun, Dan Werner. He's my uncle. God, he was fun. There was this he was in his early 30s, I would think. I like Dan Werner. He's a runner, hard worker too. And in his early 30s, God, I would have been I don't know, early 30s, but I was aged less than 7. Had some dog puppies. And then took them 30 minutes away to probably Marion, close to Freeman. Call it Freeman anyhow. And we're riding back. So it's like there are all these puppies, and I don't know why they went there. So we were, my sister was with me in the car going there. And we're coming back. So all these puppies are making a little bit of noise in the car. And he's driving us back home like 25 minutes. I mean, he's got his career going on. He's got already 3 kids. He's got his own struggles that he's overcoming. Great guy. And now he's with a niece and a nephew with puppies in his car. It's like, this is no purpose. I assume that. But he was in the police or Warren. Something of nature. So there's a gun on him. He wanted to like kill the puppies, and we're crying in the back seat or something, and we're like, no, no, Dan, don't kill the puppies, Dan, no, woo. Which is funny. I love conflict, though. I do. So I look at that as a virtue. I look at it as fun. It's loving. It makes me smile. It makes me laugh, and that brings warmth. So Dan's a good guy. He doesn't age at all. He's a runner. We had a few laughs a couple times. I think that's it. So yeah, either in the Midwest and you got one relationship or more outside the Midwest, and that's exciting. Woo! That's exciting. All right, see you.